tonight, Target 7 focuses on Tera Chavez. Her death remains a mystery to this day.
Initially, it was called a suicide. Now, investigators say it was possibly foul play. For the first time, Tera Chavez's best friend and close confidant reveals more about the young woman. Target 7's Natalie Swaby has the exclusive interview.
A beautiful mother with two young kids, a plan to start a new life, and a bullet that shattered everything. Tera Chavez died from a gunshot wound in October 2007. The weapon used belonged to her police officer husband.
Saying it for suicide.
Correct. It didn't make any sense to me.
One of Tera Chavez's best friends agreed to speak with Target 7. She asked us not to identify her because she is afraid. She feels there's something sinister behind Tara's death.
We all knew it wasn't a suicide.
Her friend says Tara would never have left her kids.
She would do anything for them.
And the young hairstylist also had a plan to open her own business.
She had made plans with her father to actually, build a salon.
But her friend says something was smoldering just beneath the surface of this promising young life.
I know in months leading up to her death, she had mentioned, that she was finally done. She wanted a divorce. She tried to stick it out, I think, as long as she possibly could.
She claims Tara's 7-year marriage to Levi Chavez, an Albuquerque police officer, was falling apart. Still, she says Tara was ready to pick up the pieces.
She was happy. She was ready to move on with her life. It was almost like she was looking forward to it.
But deputies weren't quite ready to move on from her death. After a deeper investigation, law enforcement changed the cause from suicide to undetermined. The sheriff's department named Tara's husband Levi a person of interest, but to this day, no one's been charged with any crime in connection with Tara's death.
He's gone through hell. He's lived for the last 2.5 years. Not with a real case. If it was a real case, something would have happened a long time ago. It's been gossip and rumor.
Levi Chavez's criminal defense lawyer says his client has been through enough, but yet the investigation drags on. A difficult case made even more so by what the sheriff says happened after Tara's death. Levi Chavez's fellow APD officers rushed to the scene. According to an APD spokesperson, the officers assisted in grief counseling, then cleaned up much of the blood with Valencia County deputies' consent once those deputies were done with the scene. The officers' reasoning? They did not want the Chavez children to see what happened to their mother. But with that evidence removed, investigators found it incredibly difficult to figure out whether a crime was committed.
You're still actively pursuing this case?
Yes, definitely.
After 2.5 years, Tara's friends and family can only wait.
I know I do. I want it to end. I want to find out the truth. I want to know what happened. I want to know what happened that night.
For Target 7, I'm Natalie Swaby.
A civil lawsuit in this case continues now. As for Levi Chavez, he was placed on administrative leave from November 2007 until August 2009 and was paid about $74,000 during that time. Now, shortly after Target 7 began investigating city employees on administrative leave, Chavez was switched to administrative duty. Today, he works at the Animal Welfare Department. APD says after it received reports from the Valencia County Sheriff's Department, it will conduct an internal affairs investigation.